Hey reefers, welcome back to the channel. The purpose of this video today is to show you what is achievable in terms of coral growth in a 10-month period on a new tank setup. Corals range from softies, LPS to SPS. First comparison here is the left side of my front view. I managed to collect four different time periods over the last 10 months. Keep in mind that not all of these dates are equally spaced out. As you can see at the top, image 1 and 2 are 5 months apart, while the other two are 2 months and 3 months apart. As you can see, there is tremendous growth no matter the coral we are looking at. From the Zoa garden at the bottom and the fast-growing green goblin Anacropora. There's also a chalice in the middle and some distant SPS at the top. I must say that the green goblin is one of the fastest growing SPS and is very easy to keep, so a great beginner SPS coral. Focusing on those SPS in the top back of the previous angle, here I have from top to bottom a green yellow tort. This tort doesn't encrust much at the base and started to grow in a more tabling manner. Moving down to the rainbow loom that spent most of the year encrusting a base, I started to get annoyed that he wasn't growing upwards, and so I finally decided in August to take a blade to the tips and irritate the tissue to promote healing and growth. By now, the base is so large that I have new tips growing in multiple areas of the base. I'm not sure how that's going to look once it grows out even further, but I can only imagine multi-colonies off to the sides. Directly below the rainbow loom is a millipora that I don't have a name for. I also can't entirely remember what color it was when I purchased it. Part of me thinks it was pink, purple, orange, but now I'm not really sure. Presently, it's growing well. It has a purple-blue color. Who knows, maybe if I place it under strong part, I would have the orange that I thought it had. Or it's possible that it was unhealthy due to a recent import when I had purchased it. In this shot, you will more closely see the mummy eye chalice, which has grown significantly over the past 10 months. Okay, so here I'm pretty amazed by the growth on this torch. I purchased it with two heads. I know it was an aquacultured torch, which I believe helps with the speedy growth. At this point in time, I have no idea how many heads there are anymore. If I had to guess, likely 15? I also wanted to point out that my nutrients weren't always stable throughout the 10 months. Most of the time, I'm battling low nutrients in nitrates and phosphates. Between February and July, I managed to get my nutrients up, but that didn't sustain. And by October, my nutrients bottomed out, which likely contributed to slower growth in many corals. Actually, the one coral in my tank that got really pale due to the nutrients was my rainbow loom. It's finally got its color back as I work on keeping the nutrients up. I also noticed that there's certain corals you pay less attention to and don't really notice the growth until you look back at photos. The red digitata at the top is an example of a coral like that for me, where I didn't notice much growth in the first few months. This, of course, is another easy and fast-growing SPS. Here, we have a Miyagi Tor. This SPS is also easy to keep and is a fast grower, as you can see here. It's a purple and green tor, and from my experience, loses the green when in higher par. If you're looking for a predominant green-purple mix, you'll need to keep it in lower par. In my frag tank, the Miyagi Tor has a lot more green and is getting less than 200 par. This Miyagi Tor here started to shade itself. The light was not getting through to the bottom stem area, and so by July, I started seeing bleaching under the small colony. By October, the algae was growing over top the bleached area, and has not progressed since. Lastly, the right side of my tank has a few more corals for comparison. I got this purple Gorgonian from a fellow reefer a while back, and I was convinced it was not growing. Not even an inch since I got it. Boy, was I wrong. I only noticed when I put together this video. As you can see on the zoa side, the bloodsucker zoas are super fast growing and appear to be outcompeting some of the other zoas. There was a blue patch in the middle there that I had to remove because it didn't grow and was getting engulfed by the bloodsuckers. At this point, they're growing all over the floor of the tank. Let me know what you think I should do. I have a few zoas that are growing all over the bottom of the tank. Part of me thinks maybe I should have a zoa carpet or just maybe razor blade them off. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching.